Pandora, a planet that once knew only peace and prosperity under the fair and noble direction of the Atlas Corporation. But there were those that sought to disrupt our perfect existence. Thieves and murderers, perverts and scoundrels. The lawless garbage unleashed an unspeakable evil upon Pandora, not known since the age of the gods. But together, we shall not despair. Atlas has not forgotten you. We are returning and will restore order and security to your planet. When we arrive...
Bullshit. I have choked on the disingenuous lies forged by their corporate greed my entire life, and it is a meal I will no longer stomach. Atlas is here for two things, power and revenge, and the order they do it in is irrelevant. We share a common enemy, you and I. The reward for your death is second only to mine. That alone should be reason for you to join my cause. But if it is not, and your greed precedes you, then you will gain access to all of their weapons. Their invasion stockpile will be yours. Athena, out.
Late. We must speak immediately, but I'm afraid for my own security, and therefore you must jump through a hoop or two. Talk to the mechanic. He knows where to find me. And a word of caution. Don't touch him if you ever want to eat with your hands again.
To face your first real challenge. I hope you've toughened up enough.
Ah, yeah! maze room for more loot.
Journey. You must listen. Who I am is not important. The first thing you must know, the vault is real. People will mislead you. They will try to use you, not be swayed in your purpose. The vault is here, and we will find it. This world is full of dangers. Steel yourself and go. I'll be watching.
Why don't you come over here and chat a while? It's always nice for a fellow to have company out here. I hate to send you away. Great company and all, but I gotta take it. Thank you.
Are you the one killing all the crab when people ask? The catch a ride near Firestone is more busted than my mama's girdle parts. Real appreciate you taking a poke at that. The system, not my mom. Hat dog down the scale. Back then, know what I'm saying?
And effect.
Hey, why don't you come over here and chat a while? It's always nice for a fella to have company out here.
Having another soldier on the field. This damn thing.
Hey, newcomer. I've been looking for you. Thanks. There are just some things that are too hard to do without the use of my eyes. Hey, now, if you ever need anything, anything at all.
bastard!
Another notch on my whip.
Before we cook ya!
Boy, this one gets rough! Hide away all around and record the boat!
Mounting up.
That right there is a beaut, man. My runners ain't the prettiest gal to death, but she'll put out the second you ask her. And be sure to hit the boost to know whoever wants to catch a ride with the scooter man.
Take them out! Get out of here, asshole! Kill them all!
Don't be shot out, come on!
I catch a ride, get rolling!
Did you just leap over Piss Wash Gully and one of my runners? Man, dude, tell me when you're gonna do that crap. That was awesome. Why don't you come on back? I got something for you.
Greetings, Traveler! New missions are available at the Firestone Bounty Board! Oh, come on, let's get down! Come on, everybody! Check me out, I'm dancing! I'm dancing!
You'll find a fella named Shep near the crossroads on the way to the mine. Sled skinned his entire family and built a tent out of him. Tough luck. But that Shep is a good kid. I'd appreciate you helping him.
Scram.
This man, Sledge, has something we need. You are going to get it from him. Sledge is a bad man who has done terrible things to the people of Firestone. Do what you must.
Doll Scientific Advisor, Day 1 on Planet Pandora. I have been assigned to this sector by my superiors to find evidence of abandoned alien technology similar to that found by our competitor, the Atlas Company, in the ruins on Prometheus. Technology that many believe made them the superpower they are now. This kind of find seems astronomically improbable on a rock like this, but my benefactors believe in it enough to waste my considerable talents. I've only been here for 3 hours, and I already believe this planet will be the death of me. Scientists do not chase myths and legends. Day 43 on Pandora. At least I believe it to be the 43rd day I've been here. The moonlight cycles are difficult to get used to. The planet rotation day is over 90 hours long. The people that inhabit this salted dust ball are as ignorant as I've seen in this galaxy. When I attach scientific inquiry to something like the Vault, I'm greeted with silly nursery rhymes and slack-jawed soliloquy about a man who knew a man who knew a man. They drift off into a stupor where I half imagine they're drunk or brain-damaged and are unaware of my continued presence. If I believed in hell, I would contemplate how it compared to Pandora. Ironically, such a belief would align me with these Neanderthals.
Come meet your maker!
I was woken up, hoping I was having a reoccurring nightmare. We spent more than 36 hours earlier today relocating our campsite closer to our dig site, only to be ambushed by local wildlife that's hungry coming out of hibernation. Half of my staff was eaten alive, or killed by skags. I survived by hiding under a colleague of mine who was being devoured on top of me. His name was Carl. My emotions are deadened, and I grieve for none of them. Point of fact, the only emotion I felt was that of joy. I felt joy because his chair was always more comfortable than mine. I took his chair, and then I noticed the emissive glow on the rocks at the dig site. Day 119. I sat in the shower in tears for just under an hour. This is interesting, considering we haven't had water for days. I equate my ever-decreasing sanity with that of the population of my dig site. With the investigation of the symbols and glowing patterns at the site, we finally unearthed arguably certifiable proof of the existence of alien life having been here on Pandora. But this celebration was lonely, as I only have two colleagues left. And I'm not too fond of the fat girl, Shimei. I've been told that scientific discovery requires sacrifice, but I never understood what they meant until now. The fat girl, Shimei, was crushed under an alien ruin that collapsed today. She didn't die right away and begged me to put her out of her misery as she choked on various fluids and bile. I hesitated because she was the last one alive that wasn't me. As she was choking and coughing and dying, I tried to enjoy the interaction, which I imagined to be a conversation, as I knew it was the last I would have for a while. I finally got around to smothering her so that I could continue my research. I could tell that she regretted the decision. The Skags have been waiting for this meal for a while. They will not go hungry tonight.
I got the ride. I'll TC the vehicle.
Ugh.
I got the ride.
Check out Rocket on the store.